This is probably not news for you, but we kind of messed up with this wall. I said that we didn't need insulation in here at all because we live in a tropical region, but turns out that I still need insulation to be able to handle the heat, and I don't have it there. I only have a vapor barrier. And after reading a bunch of comments in our last video of people that do insulation as a professional job and all your advice, we are gonna try to fix it. Now, we got two options. Option one, we take the whole wall down and put a layer of insulation. And option number two is try to fix it as how we have it now. And that's what we're gonna try to do. Honey.
Hi, my love.
I got the package.
Welcome back. What do we have here?
Oh, you will see. We are filling this thing up with foam. We messed up, but now it's time for us to have fun while we fix it. I'm gonna go ahead and start already sealing this wall. So we got this foam. It comes with some little thingies like this, which I can use and just put it through the wood and fill the cavities up. This is an insulating foam. It says that it's a multi-purpose, expandable, pure foam, seals, insulates, highly expandable, paintable, and sandable. I think I got all the characteristics of the sealant foam on these cans.
Today is lasagna day, and I was looking forward to this for at least 2 or 3 weeks when I decided that I wanted to make lasagna, and here we are today.
Hi, I am the one that is going to be testing the food. Wish me luck.
You don't need luck. It's going to be delicious.
We should actually call this section Ready with Freddy.
Kind of stuck right now. So you're interested in knowing all the magical ingredients in my food? No, I'm joking. It's just a simple vegetarian lasagna. Some onions, garlic, tomato, carrots, and some soy chunks. That's it, some seasoning, and then I hope it's going to turn out delicious. And I forgot about the bechamel sauce, which is basically just flour, butter, and milk. Yeah. And then you put some of the tomato salsa, then the bechamel sauce, then these like lasagna noodle things. And then the same order again and again. And some cheese on top. And that's it. I think what's missing in my kitchen is a, call it whisker, like to make better sauces. I have to say that I don't know exactly which one the right order is. If you put the red tomato stuff first and then the bechamel, or the other way around, but I will just do it however I think. Right. And now, final step, putting it into the oven. Okay, here we go.
So Freddy can have her fun with the layering thing when cooking. And I will have my fun when spraying with the foam. This is so relaxing, just hear this. I have to say that using foam as insulation, it's a lot of fun, of course, but you need a lot of it. And here where we live, they don't sell the big cans that is just used to foam the whole thing. Here you can only get these 750 milliliters cans that I need like three of these ones to fill one gap. But it's fine, I got a bunch of them and I'm almost done with applying the foam as a sealer. No, as an insulation, sorry. But this thing works as, it's like 10 different uses. Last part?
Yeah, how do I do it?
You just hold it here with two hands.
Like,
sorry, with the two fingers.
Yeah.
And press it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ooh, that looks cool. Woo! That was cool. I think that that was it.
Oh my God. What? The crazy thing about using foam as insulation is that as it is expandable, this can happen. That is just crazy. Whew. Here, it still hasn't happened, but it's probably gonna happen. And I mean, it's good for us because we know that the foam reached all the way to the bottom and it's expanding everywhere. It's sealing every small cavity and making sure everything over there is completely sealed. That is good. The bad part is that now I have a lot to clean. Oh, oh.
What?
It's not coming out.
It's not?
I managed to take most of it, but I screwed up again. Why do I just fix one thing and the next time I break something? Look, you see all these teeny pieces? Those are the finished boards. That's the last, that's the face of the boards. And I cannot let spray foam just sit in there. I tried with WD-40, but I don't have the nail polish removal thing that is the most common use for this. So I'm gonna have to just run real quick to town, get it, and come fix this. Got it. And this time I also got the quick release clamps, so the Thong & Group business is gonna move even faster. Wow, that's much better with that spray. Ooh, so easy. Today we're here united to taste Freddy's lasagna. Without further ado, let's dig into it.
Let's go. Do you know that this reminds me of the restaurant guy from Ratatouille? When he's like he's like super sit-in.
I'm having childhood flashbacks.
It's good, right? Very, very good.
Can you prepare this every day, please?
Yeah.
I would eat it every day.
Yeah, it's good, right?
And it's vegetarian, it's with soy, and it tastes just like meat.
Mm-hmm.
If you prepare this, I'll turn vegetarian. And now we're gonna use a real insulation to complete that wall. Into 50 by 102, okay. In order to make this insulation work, we are overlapping it with the foam in the back. The foam is already dried, and we made sure we left a little bit to the top. So once we place the new insulation, the aluminum insulation, because we're mixing it, sadly we didn't have enough foam to fill the whole thing. And it's also freaking expensive. We spent over $100 on foam just to fill it over mistake. And now we are combining it with the aluminum insulation. This is a double aluminum insulation. Both sides have aluminum. And we are overlapping it with the foam in the back. So we create some sort of seal. And once we put the boards on top, they're gonna press it to the back, creating a perfect seal. All right, insulation is up. We got that side, we got this side. We're missing that one in the top, but up there, we still are not gonna work yet. We're only gonna do the walls, the tongue and groove until there and there. There is gonna be a trim piece that is gonna cover that in the top, so we don't necessarily have to do the wall over there yet. Well, no, we are going back to the tongue and groove factory. It's just, I don't know.
Come here.
I just need a comfy chair.
Hey.
Can we just stay here and not do this?
Yeah, I think I need a nice evening with my boyfriend, watching a movie, cooking.
Do you want to do movie night?
Yeah. We have something for you.
Ooh. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh, we managed to get it almost even. We are pretty much done with this wall. We ran out of wood. We only prepared 4 big boards and we already used it all. But check it out. It's pretty much level with that one over there. And we went a little bit up there. Tomorrow we're gonna continue preparing more wood and finally finish this whole corner, like from there all the way to here. And we're gonna have that space for the living room.
You did such a good job. I'm so proud of you.
Hello.
Hi.
You started a movie without me?
No. Thank you. Morning in the morning.
Hi.
I think now it's time, sorry, for a good coffee and some breakfast. Today is my turn preparing the coffee. We usually take turns. Sometimes it's me, sometimes it's Rodrigo. The same actually with cooking, making breakfast, doing the dishes. It's a constant changing.
It's basically whoever wakes up first.
Yep.
And it's the hungriest.
Yeah.
Is hungriest a word? I think so.
Yeah.
That's the person that has to prepare the breakfast and the coffee.
Yeah, and so far it worked out perfectly.
And of course, not all of us are gonna work hard. We got a little cat here that is just chilling in a hammock.
I'm not sure if he's so happy about it.
Look at him. He seems happy.
He's definitely having fun in there. Hey, Ron.
Maybe that's a tropical cat.
We need more kitties.
No, we're not getting more cats now.
At least one.
Enough.
A second. We need it. I am ready.
So today we are doing more thonging group. We've been doing this for so long.
And we're loving it.
We are not loving it, I can confirm.
I kind of love it because I found my rhythm, and it's cool. I like to sand, I like to stain, I like to seal. That's my thing.
It's just one of those very tedious jobs, and I personally don't like those kind of jobs. My rhythm is like fast here, there, and there.
And I like that kind of jobs, and I like kind of the calmness that this whole thing has. But you're right, it's pretty repetitive. So
it's so repetitive that at some point it's like, I just want to do something else.
I want to do something else.
My best advice for someone who's just starting to do this thing and you know nothing about thong and groove: get yourself some quick release clamps. This will make your life so much easier. And I know that I'm not an expert over here, but this has really helped me so much. I got all this done in like less than 30 minutes. And that's it, we just completed the walls. With that, we are all set with the walls of the living room. Of course, we're still missing the trims of all that section down there, the corner pieces, but the most important part, which was the wall in itself, it's done. But now we have some shopping to do.
So, mister, do you want to tell me something about the shopping plans for today?
So today we're not buying it, but we're hunting for a couch, but we also are gonna try to get the tiles for the entire house and start placing it as soon as possible. I'm actually so excited because once we put actual tiles for the floor of a house, it's gonna change so much. Wow. That's a lot of tiles.
Yeah.
So Freddy, you are in charge of taking this decision.
This one. No.
Okay. You are not in charge of taking that decision anymore.
I think my brain is not working properly because of the heat here in the city.
What are we looking for? Like a grayish?
Yeah, gray, but I think not with this kind of pattern.
Okay.
I think more classic gray. Gray.
Wow.
That could be an option.
Okay, we're saving this one.
It's not 100% what I'm looking for, but this could be an option.
I like it. Approved.
This wasn't a success.
Yeah, we were almost kicked out of the store because we were with a camera, and so we decided to leave the store. But now we are heading to the next one.
Yeah.
Hopefully we find the tiles that we are looking for.
No, no, no. Oh, got it.
Wow.
This one's.
Is it black glass or what is it?
It looks like glass actually.
No, it's for porcelain.
Porcelain. Wow. Great. No, we don't have a porcelain cutter.
No.
We're gonna do a dark floor.
So, turns out that we couldn't get the tiles because the store was about to close. But the good news is that we were able to get some of the wood for the ceiling of the living room. Woo!
Woo! Oh, I'm happy that the AC is running.
It's like, what temperature is this?
I have no idea, it's just...
like 60, 70, I don't know, in
Fahrenheit, I have no idea.
In Celsius, it will be like 35, 36.
It's too much. So, I think we deserve some food.
I just want to go home.
Yeah, but we are not done. Right in this second, we are pulling up.
It says 7.
Yeah, Google said 7 p.m.
So we were late for everything today.
Yeah.
But I mean, at least we have an idea of what we want. Just so you guys have an idea, this is what we're looking for.
It's kind of hard to see, but it's a gray, kind of dark gray sofa bed. And?
It turns into a bed. So if we have somebody staying over, if we have a visit, they can just sleep in the couch.
Yeah, that would be ideal.
Yeah, but. I mean, we still, like, if we buy it now, we don't have space where to put it. We're just coming to check it.
We wanted to try it and sit down and see if it's comfy or not.
Yeah.
We are really, it actually says 6, that it is open until 6 p.m., but it's 5:45.
So I know. I feel like we were late for everything. We couldn't get the tiles. Now we come to check the couch. Turns out that the place is just closing. I just want to go home.
Me too.
And cuddle with a cat.
Yeah, we will do that now. Raj, we miss you. It's raining.
This is definitely not our week. This is not our week at all.
No.
We messed up with the insulation. We can't get the tiles. We can't get the couch. Know that I've got a bunch of wood in the rack of a truck. It starts raining. It's one of those weeks.
That's life. That's called life. The sushi roll is prepared for you. Now you can fill it with whatever. And Rodrigo invented the Panamanian version of homemade sushi.
Sushi is not a tradition in Panama.
With plantain.
But something that is a tradition in Panama is ripe plantain. And if you mix this with sushi, I can assure you that you're gonna love it.
Yeah.
Roll it. Roll it.
Done.
And we got a sushi roll. We were not able to get our tiles. We barely got some wood. We didn't get almost anything that we wanted to get today. But life is better when you have homemade sushi.
That's true.
And even better when you are able
to craft
chopsticks.
My love, I think you should start with a new profession, which is working in a sushi factory. That looks so good.
I wasn't that hungry, so I only made myself 3 little rolls. But I usually would eat 6. Arigato gozaimasu.
He is coming. He is coming. Let's see if he jumps on the table. Oh, yes. We just finished our sushi dinner. Rodrigo already went upstairs to go to bed. I think I will finish the evening now with a nice movie. And thank you so much for all your support, guys. We love you so much. And see you in the next video. Good night.